Somebody say it is so. Somebody say it is so. Come on, Africa, Caribbean nations, this is for you. Come on, put those hands together. Come on, let's say it together. Amen, amen.
Amen, 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 amen. It is so. It is so.
Come on, help us say it. Amen, amen.
Amen, 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 amen. It is so. It is so.
Amen, amen.
Amen, 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 amen. It is so.
Can we rehearse the promises right here? He has saved us.
Welcome to Judah Praise 2021. This year, our theme is God of Revival. You want to sit tight with expectation because you are in for an unforgettable experience.
Certainly. The truth couldn't have been said in any better way. The beginning of every event is very key, and as such, we will want to commit our ways and efforts to the hands of the Lord. To lead us in the time of opening prayer, ladies and gentlemen, Faith Asasinkasa.
Let's do it better for him.
Hallelujah. We thank God for this opportunity. Shall we close our eyes and pray? Father in heaven, we thank you for our lives. We thank you for all that you have done for us. We thank you for bringing us this far in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, you are the owner of our lives and you are the one who orders our steps. Father, you are the one who has made this event even possible. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we give you praise. We give you all the glory in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you even for making this event unstoppable. Even the pandemic will not stop us. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we give you glory. And all the honor and all the praise in the name of the Lord Jesus. We pray and even commit everything that happens here into your holy hands. We pray committing all the ministers, the singers, the dancers, even the man of God, even coming to give your word into your holy hands. I pray that let your spirit fall upon them. Father, I pray that you guide them in their utterances, in their performances. In the name of the Lord Jesus, cause them even to do according to your will. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray and even commit all those watching us into your hands. I pray that cause every one of them to be refreshed, cause them to be revived in the name of the Lord Jesus. You said in your word in Zephaniah chapter 3 verse 19 that behold, at that time you will deal with all those who afflict your people, and you will gather the outcasts and save the limping ones and give them a name and a praise in every land of their shame. I pray that let your word come to pass in the name of the Lord Jesus. I pray that you deal with their pain, deal with their distress, deal with everything that is stopping them or hindering them even from seeing your glory in the name of the Lord Jesus. I pray that you gather them from everywhere that they have been set aside, everywhere they have been rejected. I pray that you empower them even to get there. In the name of the Lord Jesus, oh God, I pray that you raise them up even as signs and wonders. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray and even commit ourselves even into your hands. That Father, raise us up even in this generation to be mighty forces, people who will demonstrate your power, people who will reveal to the whole world that indeed you are alive. In the name of the Lord Jesus, whilst others are trying to disprove your existence, others are searching for evidence to prove that your word is not true, we acknowledge that you exist, you are the owner of our lives, and you are the creator of the whole universe. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we confess that we are not products of evolution. We are not products of science in the name of Jesus, but you created us with your own hands, and you made us in your own image. We pray, oh God, that cause us all the days of our lives to manifest your glory. I pray, oh God, this is a moment of revival. Cause every soul to be revived. Cause every soul to be empowered. In the name of the Lord Jesus, oh God, I pray that after this event, we will go forth singing your praise and to the glory of your name and to the honor of your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. God bless you so much, Faith. My name is Netta Pasram. And the fine gentleman next to me is
Roy Abuaji John.
And today we'll be your hosts.
All right, so let's get into it. So David said that I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. At this juncture, we will want to enter into a time of worship and praise. So, children of the Lord, get your hallelujah on and welcome friends of God.
Friends of God, put your hands together, put your hands together.
Hallelujah. It's a great thing to be in the presence of the Lord. We want to enter into a time where we adore Him with our song. And so anywhere that you are, in your room, in the house, wherever, I just want you to join us even as we worship the name of the Lord. At this moment, I just want you to lift up your voice, and I want you in your own words to say how great God is, to say that God, you are great, God, you are mighty, God, you are holy. There is none like you, there is none like you, there is none beside you. There is none holy like you, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. You are worthy to be praised, worthy to be adored, worthy to be magnified. Lord, I lift up your name in the name of Jesus Christ. You are the one who sits on the circle of the earth. You are the one, you are the one, you are the one who created everything. In your own likeness and in your own image have you created us. And now we give you the fruit of our lips in the name of Jesus Christ. Like never before, O God of revival. Even as we stand before you in worship, we pray, O God, that you revive our hearts and our lives in the name of Jesus Christ.
He has made me glad.
I will
Lift up your voice. up your voice. Once again, yes, Yeshua, yeah. I saw for Yehovah. For a change tonight. Is somebody ready for a change tonight? Is somebody ready for a change tonight? Clap your hands. Put your hands together. We are telling God to arise in the midst of his people tonight. Lift your voice and sing. One thing we ask. One thing that we desire. That as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. I don't think you got it. Let's do it again. One thing. One thing that we desire. That as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Come on, get up on your feet and say,
oh my God.
oppressed but not crushed, persecuted not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I'm blessed beyond the curse, and His promise will endure, but His joy is gonna be my strength. Oh, the sorrow may last for the night.
Of God for this time of jubilation and reverence.
Oh. All right, so let's get into it. For every occasion there is a purpose. Judah Praise over the years has taken over social responsibility projects, and this year is no exception. To give us the purpose for today's gathering is the president of the Judah Praise Committee, Graham Arthur Kenneth. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome him.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is my distinguished pleasure to welcome you to this year's Judah Praise 2021. This year's Judah Praise tends to be the 20th anniversary in the Judah Praise franchise. Over the years, we have tried to curb some societal concerns that relate to us medically, and we have done so many across over the years. We have also done this alongside worship and praise, so we just don't do worship and praise. We try to curb societal concerns that relate to us medically. Some of the things we have done so far include buying cardiac monitors for the Komfo Anokye Teaching Hospital. We have also tried to sensitize people on neonatal jaundice, which kills thousands of children and millions of children across the world. We have also tried to sensitize people on HIV and AIDS, letting them know how it is and what it's about. This year, our project is to try and settle the bills of the children at the pediatric unit. We have had so many children at the pediatric unit who, for one reason or the other, can't have surgeries done for them or can't afford to pay their bills to be able to leave the hospital. Our other project focuses on our fourth-year medical student, a sister of ours, Rita, who has been diagnosed with cancer of the pelvic bone. So this year, that is what we are trying to tackle. Now, 2020, as we all know, has been a topsy-turvy year. The least we say about it, the better. So right now, as the Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1, that there is a time for everything, and there is a time for every business under the sun. Right now, right here, it's a time to praise and worship our God of revival. So at this point, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to sit back, relax, and enjoy. Don't just be someone or an audience of the show, but be a partaker, so that the God of revival will revive all that we have lost. Thank you very much. Welcome once again.
Amen. Amen. Are you ready for what is coming? In the world of art, there are realms where words which were first written are brought to life. Amen. In fact, we are about to encounter what is called an oral poetic ministration.
Ladies and gentlemen, to bring us this oral poetic ministration, kindly welcome
Samuela Obiri Yaboa.
Revival, revival, revival. We hear revival and begin to think of the lost souls out there, living in the dark and being blinded to all that Christ did and won for us. We hear revival and we can't help but think of the great men of old who, through diligent pursuits for more of God, brought a change to the world and routed great miracles through the working of the Spirit in them. We hear revival, but we fail to see that it involves me and it involves you. Paul to the Thessalonians, God to the people of Israel, each did make mention of a keeping of the fire on the altar burning and of a not quenching of the Spirit. But we feel to have lost the meaning to all these. Revival begins in me and you and him and us. Let's not forget that God uses a man to bring revival to a place. So before we shift our attention to them, let's ask ourselves, is the fire on our altars still burning and in flames? What happened to our closest lives? What happened to beholding his beauty and inquiring in his temple? What happened to sincerely wanting to spend time with him and be with him and minister to him and see him in all that we engage and partake in? What happened to personal revival? We are consistently present at church, having a full marked attendance to every Christian event, not only anticipating but yet also participating in every meeting and assembly, holding on to all the portfolios and bearing all the titles, but still feeling so empty within, still lacking the personal and experiential knowledge of who God is and how much we mean to him. From our morning devotions to our quiet times, from our ministrations to frequenting our church premises, Everything seems to have become a cliche. Everything has become a performance and mere religion. All we seek to avoid is to prevent explaining the reason for our absence, but not really wanting more of Him. And when the day ends, we retreat to our beds feeling so tired and empty and dry, because we fail to minister the life He called us to impact in the world above. Everything was nothing but a performance. But what if God moved again in a way that was so undeniable? What if we experienced events that left us speechless, totally unexplainable? What if the desire to see life transformed was unquestionable, and we indeed experienced the surge of a revival? Going all out in our work for Christ is the journey of a great prize. We can't afford to look back and say, we ended up just like the rest of them. It is about time. God is igniting a movement of people. He is calling His army to move outside the walls of the steeple. We are a people created wonderfully and fearfully in His image, taking the nations and changing the world beyond man's limits. Sons and daughters prophesying His fame, all for one name. Catching on to the fire that comes from love and radiating the glory placed within us by the Father above. Even as the Spirit through us breathes the resurrection wind through a valley of dry bones and causes an awakening in millions of souls who once had hearts of stone. Irrespective of where we are, in the business arena or in ministry, we are a daring generation going to stand unashamedly to represent our King of Kings. We seek nothing but have the kingdom stand number one. Revival is you. Revival is now. Are you ready? Thank you.
Another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate God for the blessing over her life. Amen.
Amen. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 57, the verse 15, "For thus says the high and lofty one, who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy.
I dwell in the holy and high place with him who has a contrite and humble spirit.
To revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. A blank parchment is lifeless until a pen creates a melody. And music is a privilege to all who hear her sing."
It is with honor that we welcome the anointed vocals. Ladies and gentlemen, friends of God.
You want to do it better till the last person takes the stage?
anticipate.
We anticipate
a mighty move.
A mighty move.
We're leaning.
We're leaning.
Trusting.
Trusting.
Patiently
waiting.
Waiting.
We're desperate. Stretched us, the world has drained us, but we know that when we come to you, you would pour out on us rivers of living water. And so we open our hearts today, even as we worship you. We pray, oh God, that you would pour out on us, you would pour out on us, Father. Oh God, tonight we humble ourselves. We humble ourselves before you, oh God, and we are asking you, oh Father, Holy Spirit, Son, move in our midst. Move in our midst. We're asking you to come. 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 Holy Spirit.
Come.
Come.
Inhabit in us.
Come.
Stay with us.
Come. Holy Spirit.
And we need you to move. Of Jesus. Hallelujah.
God of revival. We've come here tonight expecting the move of God in our lives. And we're going to sing the song to testify to that. If you can sing the song, sing with us. And let's make some declarations here tonight. Hallelujah.
Anticipating the move of God.
tonight, what we have come to do is to prophesy into the atmosphere. Oh yes, we came here with an expectation, and that is for God to move in our generation. We want Him to move in our affairs. We want to see His move in our family life, in our jobs, in our societies. We want to see Him move in our schools. And no, we won't be satisfied until we see that move. Oh Lord, it is our prayer tonight that You will come, that You will come and move amongst and within us, before us, behind us. We want to see change is coming.
Change is coming.
Change is coming. And I'm expecting a move. I don't know about you, but for us, we're expecting His move.
Expecting the rain of God to shower down on us tonight? Is anyone expecting the rain of God to shower down on us tonight? Amen.
Lord tonight.
Do you want more of Him? Do you want more of Him, oh Lord?
Hunger that won't die.
It's undeniable.
It's undeniable.
How
This is still Judah Praise 2021, and we are communing with a God of revival. Up next, we have a group that is known to execute with excellence drama, poetry, and dance.
Tonight, it's there to ignite life in every dead area of your life through the changing scenes of drama. A round of applause, Aroma of Christ.
Talking plans, what?
Who took what? Spa champions, no, MG, 2006.
I don't know, yeah, I'm in. Oh, yeah, I'm in to be. What's this?
Sure. So, go be play plus me. Come on, dear club. Come on. Come on, that's all you know. You shall pass. Apu. You go play again.
Sure. Play. Let's go, one Ghana, one Ghana.
One city.
Yeah.
Hey, the Jilo, Jilo, now cry. Jilo. Oh,
Pekasa cry.
Why is that a place back?
Masa, shut up. Ah, you like talking? I don't like this. What's this? I don't have.
Play again.
I don't have.
I'll win you again. What sound? So we play some games, you know, win so much. I mean, you know.
Master, this is not about skills. You are just being lucky.
I'm being lucky.
Yeah.
Let me play last one.
Let's play. I get another
I'll
one.
I'll win this one. Also, bring the other one, Ghana. Hey, Alaska, today they will win your boys, and I was set to.
You win. Why?
I win. Check. I win.
Ah.
Hey. Shit.
Bro, what's up? If you know, go talk left arm.
Charlie, guys. Oh. I know if he talks safe. Oh.
Hey. What's up? You know if he talks safe. What?
Charlie, KDB. KDB. I sat down. I conducted research. Concrete research. Babu scanner shit.
Ah, see, you have been advising you that you have to stop this betting thing that you've been doing. See. Those betting companies, they are just out there to capitalize on the love of football and take your money.
I've told you this before. Listen, see, as a young, responsible man, you should be able to take care of yourself.
Listen,
see,
listen.
You should be financially independent from your parents. And then maybe I don't meet me at Tamao. I mean, chilling money, shadow money.
And money for the girls. Exactly, bro. Hey, you see, the hand that doesn't work will not eat.
Say,
hey, you be young black boy. If I do something, Charlie,
look, guys, look like you don't get what I mean. I'm not saying betting is that bad, though, but it's like somebody who takes alcohol or somebody who has sex. There's a tendency for you to abuse it. You remember this, Pastor? Mensa Utabo, he says that when the devil realized that people were shy of sticking Luto, then he brought a more convenient way, which is my bet.
Hey, have you heard bet way?
Bet what?
It's the way. What are you talking about?
Stop online. What's up, Luke, man? On your phone, what's up? Who's the enemy Bible? You need me to read your Bible.
Do you have a Bible on your phone? John
3:16.
The Bible says that even when Jesus Christ God himself, John 3:16, even when
John 3:16. If I John 3:16. Hey, Master, are you how you feel like?
The apostles asked us to the devil to replace Judas.
John 3:16. The disciples were betting on horse racing. What are you talking about?
Hey, you people can lie.
Who can lie?
If I don't read my Bible, it's not this particular verse.
You will be two-faced.
Two-faced.
You will be playing chacha. Chacha, see, you're winning yourself. But as you go, take bet. You say your own business.
Left.
Master, what I'm saying is betting is of no use. You better stop before it's too late. Hey, Charlie, you're up high. Presido. Presido, good afternoon. Yes, please. I'm in another important meeting. Yes, please. I'll be there. I'll be there very soon. I'm coming. Charlie,
your mommy that.
Nah, Presido.
Now I'm saying president.
No. CMF president. Insura.
CMF president.
Yeah.
How she be calling you?
Oh, Charlie, it's time for service. I've organized the boy this setup. So I for leave. Yeah. But I come for day. So you do how you go crushing. Charlie, so I'll pay you, relax. Sewa. Which one is this one? Me pen temu. So well, I've told you I will pay you. I will pay. Do you have black tape? The ones that the electrician uses. Say what well, first. Ah. Okay. So right now, because you sell in this provision shop on this campus, you now call yourself and you are giving yourself titles. Hey, Charlie boys, any of you? Charlie, what's up? This is a public place. Why are you doing it for you? Oh, Charlie Sean. Ah. Man, is they here? They do this for you. Oh, Charlie Sean. Ah. This is public place. Ah. You have to stop this. Ah. People are here. Ah. Why are you going? Oh, people are here. You have to stop this. You can't do it in the room or something. Master, stop. Ah. What's this? Charlie, stop. Ah. Stop. Oh. Master. Linda. Oh no, I came here not so long ago. Oh really? I left my phone by the drum set and I came here in search of black tape for the cable. Yeah. Oh really? Wow, then that's a relief. Sure. Okay, so when you are done, just call me. Okay. Charlie, boys, you have to stop this.
Are you talking
today? Yeah, why, what's up?
That's the girl I told you about.
Ah, which girl?
Ooh, are you acting? That's the girl on Tuesday, how you
ah, the one who's mere sight make you hypoxic, you know. She did. Charlie, then this is your chance. Follow my lead. Linda.
Hello.
Are you done? Don't mind him. He's just being funny. Make what they're in a So you guys, upon all the advice I've been giving you, still go binge drinking. This is Alaska we are talking about. You for believe in the boy. Believe in the boy. Charlie, he'll be sorted. Don't worry. Charlie. He will be fine. Hey, It'd be like time casual. Charlie, I have to go to church right now. So you do a junior.
Relax. But you see, as we go, by you look, you know, boss. Why do you two tell me the girls are nasty?
Me, I know, boss. That why you don't know.
Challenge me, I'm there. As we go, I know, say, Linda, you can't tap last week. Challenge, I go vibe and smoke. Oh, I see now, she's the gang, she's the boss, she's the gang. Hey, shall know my poor boy.
Swamp now, Jay.
Bro, she said, what the funny me grab, you see? I was sitting just behind the preacher.
Wait,
preacher, let you pay.
Yeah. Ooh.
Why is this
man
at the church service?
Come on,
back.
Yeah,
when people are desired to be in the presence of God, he was rather desired to be in
the presence of a woman. Oh, that's Alaska. So, look. I'm going to get him, so see, I go buy my soul.
That one, they won't blow up my phone. Don't
look. Hey, how did they take your number?
Oh.
Hey, this is the local source. Hey, me let me tell you something. Nothing for this word inside. Mm-hmm. Funny. Pass me the girl she came. She did just not give fire to. She gets your number and die. Morning devotion, afternoon devotion, dawn devotion, Tuesday devotion. Well, Obey Queen Griffin girls. That's
Junior,
a wicked pass.
Yeah, you are talking as if you don't know me. Do you know me at all? Do you know me?
Yeah.
Master, I am the Viking Alaska. Why do you think they call me Viking? Why? Tell me why.
But the most serious is what Junior is saying is true. Those cafe girls there, Charlie, they'll be different with you.
Masala.
If you
think they'll be different with you. Another question is also, see, how can we live in the world?
Let's go.
Come, 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 yeah. Hey! What kwa sorry? As you can see me, I went to church. So
wait, I'm top bread, why?
What up bread? What the chain kakra me cleaning rear now?
Into main trail.
That's why I
changed. Nice sweet
oh.
Tell the mommy.
Medical school.
Who your student can come day too? Who your student can come day too? Come to be here, baby. Oh my goodness. All bad for Benny. It's me, Chong. How I?
You
bet y'all brown. Why? Sugar bread. Why?
Sugar bread.
Sugar bread.
Of course.
Y'all brown. What else here?
Of course.
Okay. Thank you very
sugar
much.
Bread. Why not?
Yeah, cool.
Hey, France, do us. Hey. United to us. How?
Honestly, Alaska, I was so happy to see you at church today. I hope you enjoyed the service.
I enjoyed the service. It was like the preacher's message was tailored for me.
Sit down.
Sure. And I don't know. I think I need to make a change. I really need to.
Wow. I'm glad you came to that realization. I'm so happy for you. Wow, I'm elated. Please, would you mind if I pray with you?
Sure.
Please, can you stand up and hold my hands? Our Father in heaven, we thank you so much for Alaska's life. We thank you that you brought him to the realization that he needs you in his life, that he needs to make a change. Even as he's come to this decision, help him to make his way towards you and ground him in you, that his life would be revived in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Please, I'm so happy for you, oh dear. I'm so happy. Wait. I think I'm out of water. I need to get a bag of water. So let me just go and get
sure,
it. Okay?
Sure.
Sister Selwa.
Oh, hi.
I'm buying a bag of water.
Okay, money. Down there.
Sure. Alaska, would you mind carrying this one?
Oh, why not?
Okay.
Porter. Hey, Porter one.
Junior.
Communal
labor. Should I help you with your Bible?
Wow. Don't worry.
Are you sure? I
will carry it. Don't worry.
Samson one.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I'm so happy.
Junior.
Hey. Aquaman.
Junior, I said, my name is bread now sent you.
Sir.
Where did you come
from? Oh, there, mommy. Spaghetti must still. Oh, mom, spaghetti. Yeah. Yes, eh?
8 cities.
Oh, there, made 3 cities, remember?
Hey!
Baby, I'm the mama!
Be like, look
at me! Oh! How? Buy a Bitcoin! Show me, baby, and I'll also want to work at you.
Spaghetti!
Yes, sir! Be a nice girl, baby!
Hey, look, man!
So, what?
I'm better, baby!
Minto bibi ao.
Oh, kalipo wa homo to ho.
Me se minto
bibi. Me wa spaghetti. Me wa tin fish. Umbe jibi.
Minto bibi
ao. Discount.
Chali. Usu unja ayde deno. Chali. Ah, you see your man today.
Ah,
Alaska.
Why, what
hey, I see your man shada gidi like gidi go interview. Hey, boy, who? What they shock me be say he signed the whole Bible. But I come manage man the unja ye. He dey swallow water. Ah, but see. I say he dey hug the woman oh.
Hey.
Give us some correct hug for here.
Hey, bro.
I saw that. You think the girl go room?
Really?
Alaska too, by this time. He's poor inside. Alaska. He's poor. The girl finish.
But don't be so surprised. Because Alaska, he just trying to.
Charlie,
so that
he left small. He the kiss sound for here. He left small. He the kiss sound.
Hey.
Yeah, he sees that day here where he do this thing. Alaska, bad man.
Charlie, you let me drop something.
Oh, I don't wait to you. Alaska. Hey. Alaska, creepy girl. Nah, he for teach me. Hey.
I want to put this thing in your dustbin.
Hey.
Why, what again?
Now, Oscar.
Farm boy.
bad boy, bad guy,
hey,
Alaska.
Man. Alaska, what's good? Hey, my boy. Hey, Charlie, I want to help. Hey, Shishu.
Hey. Maza, this is Japanese leather. What will be that? Oh my God.
guys, enough of the jokes.
Ah, but see. All jokes aside, Charlie, you don't look too churchy. Ah, this vibe by this time, Charlie. You know, for the dress like this, why they do all this thing? You started dress like Pastor Chris, all that.
Guys, something important happened in church today, and I want to share it with you.
See, they can't give you the feeling. Hey. You take the go-go. Tell them, say you take the go-go. Tell them.
Hey, I can't wait to.
So as you take on guru, what happened? Give me filler.
So you guys know how I've been trying to get Linda to like me and all of that.
Wait. Trying to get her to like you. Trying. But I see the hug she hug you for here. Hey, see, make her tell you something. If girl they hug you, when she do so, it means that she they love you. Hey, where you take on guru? Chale, my fella, no ne yehu diye kono chale. How you do am?
So. The thing is, I'm actually very glad I followed her to church.
You have to be glad now. Why are you doing here, bro? What are you talking about?
If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have had this opportunity to hear this life transforming message and give my life to Christ.
You mean you gave your life to Christ?
Yes, I did.
Abium. So the girl has successfully recruited you. So you turn church boy. But yeah.
So the preacher actually shared a message, and I want to share it with you guys.
And I talk to him.
Oh,
message there.
Junior.
Baby, on my phone. Oh, baby. Really?
Oh, Junior, relax and listen to him, eh?
What?
Listen.
You people with the church boys. So, message, I make you.
Alaska, so.
So, the preacher's words actually revealed the broken state of my heart and how I was in need of saving. I mean, I always thought because I was born into a Christian home and I attended church every once in a while, I was in good standing with God. I mean, I could call myself a Christian and still do everything that I wanted to do. I filled my life with so many empty things. Gambling, pornography, drinking. Yet, I felt dead inside. The preacher said the only way I could experience true joy was by coming to Christ. There I was in church, trying to impress a lady. And yet the message took hold of my heart and caused me to examine myself. I realized I had been on the wrong path for so long. I had drifted into a state of lifelessness, and it was only God who could help revive me. Guys, I gave my life to Christ today, and I want you guys to do the same. There's a lot of repenting we have to do. And I'm going to be very, 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 very honest. Lukman.
Yeah, Alaska.
How long have I known you?
Since SHS times.
That's right. Approximately 7 years now. And in the 7 years I've known you, Lukman, you've attended church every single Sunday. And even on weekdays. And yet you failed to invite us even once. Lukman. In the 7 years I've known you, you've not had any kind of spiritual impact in my life. I've known Linda for just 2 weeks, so look, man, just 2 weeks, and she has totally transformed my life. You encouraged and motivated our sinful behaviors. You even joined in. Look, man, now I'm just glad the scales have fallen off my eyes, and I'm back right with God.
Hey, Kwame Shakespeare. What can be? Yeah, in terms of record.
Alaska. In fact, I'm ashamed of myself.
Boy.
all these years, I've been able to do what Linda did. And I'm so sorry. Please forgive me, okay? I'm so sorry about that.
Look, man, you see, the thing is, forgiveness is not mine to give you. But the most important thing is that you repent of your sins and you get back right with God. Junior. Oh, Timmy.
Minty was the same.
And Uncle Joe.
Hey, see, make I tell you something. Make you no try that guilty cold Christian church boy thing from a top.
Oh.
Nobody force you. You see you, man. You say you fall. You go church, come out. Make you no try that thing from a top now. Charlie, I'm not in the mood.
Oh, Junior. You know, we've been tight ever since we were put in the same anatomy group in first year.
Ain't it then?
Oh. We've gone to clubs together. We've run girls together. We've done a whole lot that, in retrospect, we shouldn't even have done. But, Junior, now, I'm glad I've seen the light. And I want you to see it too. What we've...
Hey, see, Master, see.
Oh.
I no go sit here and make you disrespect me like that too. You carry your body, go church. You go come and I repent. And I've examined. Oh, your consultant now by exam, Yobi.
Oh.
And I'm dead inside. Mr. Zombie. Me da me cover, I'm calling me spaghetti. Now me da mini time, I'm de.
Junior,
me nyawa dey.
Oh,
Master, me tie da okan. Say wa me this carnival why? Okay.
Look, man, I didn't mean to make you feel bad, though. But the truth just had to be said.
Alaska, there is no need for you to apologize. In fact, the word that she said, they hit me like ton of the brick and. I'm really sad and I'm so glad that you finally held me accountable.
Well, thanks should be going to God, and it's just unfortunate Junior wasn't willing to listen.
Yeah, it's very unfortunate.
But the best thing we can do for him now is to pray for him and hope that he gets back to know God.
Surely. So let's pray for him.
Sure.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so grateful. We thank you for everything that you have done in our lives. We thank you that once again you have shown us your love. Even while you are yet sinner, you came and you died for us. We pray even for our brother Junior, just as you did to Saul on his way to Damascus. May he encounter you so that he will also come to the saving knowledge of you. In the mighty name of Jesus that you have prayed with so much thanksgiving. Amen.
Charlie, I'm going to the room, so...
Sure. Right. So let's go.
All right.
Are we ready? That was you. Look, ma. That was you.
People of God, you may still be wondering how your cares may be eased. The only way is worship. Worship is your best bet. We continue with Judah Praise 2021, inviting friends of God.
Broken. before the King of Kings. Amen. Take all.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, somebody. Do you believe there's power in the name of Jesus? Amen.
Oh,
situation is deliverance.
Deliverance in the name of Jesus.
There's no power to save you. There's freedom.
Deliverance in the name.
Right, the atmosphere is ripe for the presence of God, and the word of God is coming to us very soon. The man of God bringing us the word today happens to be the son of the general overseer and founder of Calvary Charismatic Center. He is married to one wife. He's been blessed with two beautiful children. He has a ministry to the youth that is driven to empower them to manifest their destinies and carry the torch that is burning. I believe that there is no other person fit to exhort us on revival than our very own. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome Pastor Joshua Obeng. You want to do it better till he takes the stage. Do it better, do it better, do it better.
Amen. It's a wonderful joy for me to be with you here at Judah Praise. And wherever you are, I hope that you can be a part of us, being focused on your camera, knowing that although you are at home alone or you are at home with a few people watching, that you are still a part of what we're doing here. Today I want to talk about the winds of revival. Our theme is the God of revival, but I want to talk about the winds of revival. Luke 12, 54 to 55 says, he also said to the crowds, when you see a cloud rising in the west, you say at once, a shower is coming, and so it happens. And when you see the south wind blowing, you say there will be scorching heat, and it happens. What Jesus was saying is that winds determine what an atmosphere is. Atmospheres are determined by the wind. And every time there's going to be rain, the winds will tell us so. The winds tell us what kind of season there is supposed to be. The wind tells us what kind of weather that is coming. And Jesus was saying that when you observe the wind, you know what kind of weather that is coming. And I came to announce to you that the winds of revival are blowing. And because the winds of revival are blowing, God's people have got to be prepared. In scripture, there are seven symbols of the Holy Spirit. Water is a symbol of the Holy Spirit because it flows. And the Spirit of God has a way of flowing into people's life. Oil is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. Because in the Old Testament, they would take the oil and pour it and anoint prophets, kings, and priests. Wine is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. So the Bible says, do not be drunk with wine, but be drunk with the Spirit of God. Fire is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. The Bible says that when the Holy Spirit fell in the book of Acts, it was like fire. It was like tongues of fire. The dove is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. When Jesus Christ was anointed in scripture, the Bible says this dove came and rested upon him. And if you are under the sound of my voice, I pray that the Spirit of God will rest upon you. The seal is a symbol of the Holy Spirit because it is what God seals you with, the Spirit as your identity marker. Because without the Spirit, it is the Spirit that testifies that we are children of God. The wind, therefore, is also a symbol of the Holy Spirit. So that when the wind begins to blow, we know that the Spirit is about to move. And I'm about to tell you something. If you're listening and watching us at Judah Praise, that the wind of the Spirit is already moving and God is about to touch you in a mighty way. So Ezekiel 37 verse 1 to 12 talks about the valley of dry bones. The valley of dry bones. The valley of dry bones. And the Bible says that a lot of things were dead in the dry bones. And if you read Ezekiel 37 verse 1, it says that the hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones. Now the man of God says that God's hand came upon him and took him to the place where it was dry and it was full of bones. Because God will always send you to a place sometimes that is dead, because he knows that he's bringing revival to the place. And many of us think that God will always send you to great places, places that are wonderful. God does not always do that. Sometimes God will send you to a place that everything is dead, that you don't want to be at, because he has revival in mind. And the Bible says that God sent Ezekiel to a place that was dead, and the hand of God was upon him. And the Bible says in 37 verse 2 that the hand of God led him to the place and it told him to prophesy. Now, it showed him the state of the bones he was supposed to prophesy over. The state of the bones were dry and there were many. They were dry and many. While we read Matthew 12 verse 43, we find out that evil spirits dwell in dry places. Matthew 12 verse 43 says that, but the unclean spirit has gone out of a man. It roams through dry places in search of rest. So that means that every time an unclean spirit is moving, is looking for a dry place to rest. So the drier the place, the likelihood that it becomes an abode for evil spirits. And the place was dry. The place was dead. But God sent his man into the situation to prophesy to the situation. And sometimes you find yourself in a place that is dead. You find yourself in a place that is totally dry. But God will send his man or his woman into that place to prophesy. And I see that God is sending somebody to a place to change and turn that place around. There is going to be a revival that God is going to do a mighty thing with you. Is anybody here? Say amen. So the Bible says that God showed him the place.
And the Bible says in Ezekiel 37 verse 4, it says, again he said unto him, prophesy upon these bones. Say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Now what is prophecy? Prophecy is simply speaking what God has asked you to say. Prophecy is saying whatever message that God has put in your spirit to say. And so what God was saying to him is that don't look at what is going around, prophesy to these bones. Don't look at what is happening around you, speak to this bone. I don't know what word that God has put in your mouth, but I came to tell somebody, prophesy, speak that word. And when you begin to prophesy, you begin to see what God has said should happen. So the Bible says he began to prophesy. And when he began to prophesy, there was a sound. And in a few, you know that one of the things about Judah praise is that a sound is being produced. Because every time there is prophecy, there is a sound. God responds with a sound. And I hear a sound coming from heaven and saying, let there be revival. Let the dead things come back to life. Let the things that the enemy slaughtered and destroyed come back to life. Let dry places arise again. And I came to prophesy to somebody, there will be a revival. And the Bible says when he began to prophesy, there was a sound. Because every time we speak and we cry out to God, God responds with a sound. The Bible says in the book of Acts, they were in the upper room crying, and the Bible says that there was a sound of a rushing wind. Because every time we cry out to God, God responds with a sound. And may God respond with a sound on us tonight. May God respond with a sound at Judah Praise tonight. May God respond with a sound in your life tonight. May God respond with a sound. And the Bible says, there was a shaking. There was a shaking. There's a shaking coming. I said there's a shaking coming. Now, it is important for us to know that shaking does not happen in dead places. Because in dead places, everything is dead. Nothing moves in dead places. Because the bones were dead. They were dead and dried out. But when they began to prophesy, when he began to prophesy, there was a shaking, there was a movement. I don't know what has died, but there's coming a movement. I said, I came to prophesy over this. And this is not a sermon. I came to prophesy over somebody that there is a shaking, and God is going to shake things and turn things around on your behalf. There was a shaking, and the Bible says the bones began to come together. The bones began to come together because the skull then began to look for the shoulders, and the shoulders began to look for the body, and everything that was scattered around started coming together. And sometimes there are things that are scattered in our lives that we don't even see are left from right. But when the bones began to come together, when the bones starts coming together, know that God is about to do something. When we prophesy, God brings our lives back together. And the Bible says the fourth thing that happened, muscles came on it. Body came on it. Muscles came on it. And you're as you listen to the sound of my voice, you're beginning to build spiritual muscle. I see somebody beginning to build spiritual muscle. You said there are things that were dead in my life, Pastor. I couldn't do those things again. But I see somebody building some spiritual muscle. Let that spiritual, anything that was dead in your life, let it come back to life in the name of Jesus. Let me develop some spiritual muscle. There was spiritual muscle came on it. And the Bible says the fifth thing, flesh came on it. But after all this, in verse 8 of Ezekiel 37, it says that, but there was no breath. The muscles had come, the flesh was on it, but there was no breath. And many times, that is the order of the day. We have got things in place, but there is no breath. Things have come together, but there is no breath. Because, they can build the house, but unless the Lord builds, they labor in vain. And there are things that sometimes it is possible for us to put things together, but when there is no breath, there is no life. When there is no breath, there is no life. I don't care what happens. I don't care what you have put together. When there is no breath of God in a thing, there is no life. The Bible says, God formed man from the dust of the earth and breathed into him. And man became a living being. That the inspiration of Jehovah gives a man understanding. It is the breath of life that brings life. And there are many times we are doing many things. You might be under the sound of my voice. You might be a doctor. You might be a nurse. You might be in another profession. But you have things put together. But there is no breath of life in your life. And so you might be alive, but you are not living. You might be walking, but you are not living. You might have everything that human beings think that is important to have, but you are not living. Until the breath comes, there is no life. And there was a body, but there was no life. And the Bible says, he looked at it, there was no breath. And the Bible said, prophesy to the winds. Prophesy to the winds. Let the winds bring breath into this. So he began to prophesy. Now the Bible talks about the four winds of the earth. The powerful wind of the north, the northern wind. When the Bible talks about the northern wind is always accompanied by lightning. It brings rain. It brings growth and increase. So he said, prophesy to the four winds. So he began to prophesy to the northern wind. The northern wind brings rain. It brings growth. It brings increase. And so tonight I prophesy to you that the northern wind is coming. It's bringing rain. It's bringing growth. It's bringing increase. And wherever that things had died, there is a north wind that blows and brings grace. It brings growth, brings increase. Then the Bible talks about the south wind. The south wind brings peace and quiet and healing and comfort. And if you're in the medical field, this is a wind for you. That the south wind brings peace, it brings quiet, it brings healing. We need healing. In our lives. We need comfort in our lives. We need peace. We need quiet. So he began to prophesy to the south wind. And I speak to you and I prophesy the word of God to you. That peace is coming in the place where there was chaos. That peace is coming in the place where there was confusion. That there is a quietness that is coming to every confusion. There is a quietness that is coming to anything that the devil, any turbulence that the devil send your way, that the south wind is coming. It's bringing healing, bringing comfort, it's bringing peace. Then the Bible talks about the eastern wind, the dry eastern wind, the wind that scorches. It is a wind that devastates. It is a wind that separates. And I know somebody is listening to me and wondering, Pastor, what good is this wind? You haven't said anything good about this wind. It's a wind that devastates. It's a wind that scorches. It's a wind that separates. Because every time the enemy comes and tries to destroy your life, tries to put you under oppression, this wind comes in and devastates the enemy. This thing comes in. This wind comes in and separates the boys from the girls. This wind comes in and silences the adversary. And I speak a wind that is coming to devastate the enemy. I speak a wind that is coming to destroy the hand of the enemy. Every attack of the enemy over your life because of this wind, in the name of Jesus, let his hand be rebuked. Let his brought his works be frustrated in the name of Jesus. Eastern wind separates. God wants to separate his children. It is this wind that blew, that Moses prophesied about, that blew, that separated the Israelites from the Egyptians. Then lastly, the last wind. The wind from the west that drives off and brings relief and the promise of rain. It brings relief and the promise of rain, the promise of blessing and transformation. The wind that brings the promise of rain. In fact, this wind, they used to call it the early rains. The wind that brings the early rains is just little drops of rain that it brings. But it promises of a bigger rain coming. But sometimes God will bring you little blessings just to promise you of the greater blessing that is to come. Oh, you didn't hear me. I said sometimes God will bring you little blessings to promise, to bring you to an understanding that he's still working in your life and that the bigger one is coming, that you should wait for it. Whatever blessing, I came to prophesy to someone that whatever blessing that you receive this year or last year, it's not the real thing. The bigger one is coming. This was just a promise of what God, of the greater things that God is about to do. And we prophesy about the west wind. And the Bible says, all of a sudden, it was not just bones coming alive. It became a great army. And although Ezekiel started out seeing dry bones, after the revival, he saw a great army. I know you see dry bones, but I came to tell somebody, if you will speak what God has asked you to speak, you are about to see a mighty army. You didn't hear what I said. I said, if you will speak what God has asked you to say, you are about to see a mighty army. If you don't quit and you keep on saying it, if you don't quit and you keep on speaking it, you are about to see a mighty army. And I prophesy there is a sound of revival coming to our generation. This is the time. This is the time. This is the hour for a mighty army. Every time the wind of God blows, it blows with the presence of God. Every time the wind of God blows, it blows with the presence of God. The north wind brings the presence. And I pray in the name of Jesus, as you watching us wherever you are, and I speak that wind, that northern wind, wherever you are, let the presence of God visit you right now, wherever you are, in the name of Jesus. That God is in that room, that God is ministering to you in a mighty way. There are some people listening to us that are sick. I speak in the name of Jesus a word of healing into this camera, that in the name of Jesus, be healed. Be healed in the name of Jesus. There are some people that are going through confusion. I speak that wind that brings quietness and peace, that God will be your peace, that the Prince of Peace will bring peace into your life in the name of Jesus. There's a wind that blows financial freedom, that blows prosperity. I pray in the name of Jesus that God will prosper you. And the wind that blows deliverance, the eastern wind, will come and deliver you also from every hand of the enemy if you're facing any affliction. In the name of Jesus, you that is under the sound of my voice. Right now, I want you to pray with me right now, wherever you are. If you want to kneel down, you can kneel down. If you want to cry out, you can cry out. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak to those things that be not as though they were. And your word says that I am the head and not the tail. And I speak right now to any dead situation in my life. I speak a revival. I speak resurrection. That the same power that raised Jesus from the dead, if it lives in me, it will quicken my mortal body. I pray in the name of Jesus that everything that is dead and unresponsive around me, that it will start to respond in the name of Jesus. I give you praise. I give you glory. I declare it done in Jesus' name. And somebody say amen. Listen, if you're watching us, we cannot close this broadcast without telling you there are many people that need our help. There are many people in the children's department that need our help. They need our help to help pay the bills. Look, I've seen it. Many times you will go to many of these wards and there are many mothers and fathers crying. And we want to do something. Revival starts with us. Revival starts with us. Could we do something today that could bring and send a sound of revival in the wards in the Komfo Anokye Teaching Hospital Children's Department? Is it possible that we can give a seed that will send a revival in the hearts of the people and the children in that ward? That yes, God is still alive. There is no need for us to cry and pray and do everything and do all that without giving a seed that could send a revival in the hearts of these mothers and these fathers of these children. So wherever you are, if you're giving, make sure you give. You want to give $10,000? Go ahead, write a check. Write a check. Call the numbers on our screen. There are mobile money numbers on the screen. Please make sure you do call those numbers. The numbers are on your screen. Please contact someone. Make sure that you give something. There are people that want to sign a check of $10,000. If you can send it by Momo and you want to give it, make sure you contact any of the numbers down there. There are people who want to give $5,000. Go ahead and give it. There are some people who want to give $1,000. Go ahead and give it. Go ahead and give it. Don't let this thing close without doing something. There are some students. There are some of you are students. There are some people who say, you know what, I can only do $500. Do it. There are some of you say, you know what, I can only do $100. Do it. There are some of you say, I don't have all the money. I want to do it in bits and pieces. Make sure that you do. But whatever you do, make sure that you give something. Because we want to send a message of revival in the hearts of many of these children and many of these mothers and fathers in the Komfo Anokye Children's Department. We have actually a sister who is suffering from cancer of the pelvic bone that we want to help. So we want you to give in every capacity that you can. Whatever way that you can help, please do well to do that. And give something. And give something. And give something. Don't let this thing close without giving something. Don't tune off because it's time for us to give something. Just give something. Whatever you do, don't leave this broadcast without giving something. I want to pray for you. I want to pray for all the people that have made commitments to give. Yes, I know some people are giving. Keep giving. Keep giving. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. Give something. Give something. Keep doing it. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my sister. Keep doing something. Keep giving. Keep giving. keep giving. And for all those that have given, I want to pray a prayer for you. That Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will bless the work of their hands. That the same way as they have offered help to your children, we pray in the name of Jesus, offer help to them in the name of Jesus. We give you praise. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We want to thank you for being with us. Just keep on, stay tuned, because we have more for you. Thank you very much.
What a word, what a word. Hallelujah. Amen. I was so blessed by that word. Amen. Amen. In fact, tell your neighbor that your revival is in your mouth.
The revival is in your mouth.
And so prophesy.
So prophesy.
Hallelujah. In fact, yes. I see some winds blowing into people's lives. There is a north wind, a south wind, an east wind, a west wind. Amen.
Amen.
If you have been blessed like I have been, you want to say a prayer into the life of the man of God. Hallelujah. You want to prophesy that may his ministry expand. You want to pray that the expanse of the word in his mouth will reach beyond boundaries. Amen. Just open your mouth and begin to say a prayer into his life. Hatal irur atalemo shetenea retedede lebendelebo shadadai hayamanama. Even as he has prophesied revival over our lives, may he also experience revival in every aspect of his life in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. May his ministry expand in the name of Jesus. May his reach, O God, retedelebelebo sanananai. Beyond imagination. Amen.
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 People of God, you may still be wondering how your cares may be eased. The only way is worship. Worship is your best bet. We continue with Judah Praise 2021, inviting friends of God.
Venturaninga Kupo. Kukokomu Pai Fuo. Erade ma homeneso. Nama tamfuni na huse. Uyo nyamia. Okami. Let's go.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they have shown us in poetry, they have shown us in drama, they have shown us in their very first dance ministration. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready to be wowed as we welcome Aroma of Christ.
Many years ago, opportunity.
The message and opened their hearts to Christ, they surrendered and their shackles began to break. They felt deep inside that freedom they had been longing for. Their burdens were lifted. They were liberated. Christ's message to them had taken the shackles off their hands and feet, and they danced and lifted their hands to praise God.
I don't mind though. I'm glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
That there was a journey ahead of them. The lifetime of freedom also meant that challenges and fights were ahead of them, for the enemy, their captor, sin, would not rest. It was demanded that they had to be on their feet, they had to be equipped, putting on the full armor of God. They had to know this, that God was with them in this battle. And so far as God did, they too then did.
All right. Are you ready? There's a war coming your way. There's a big war. The devil's going to do some different things on you. But just tell yourself, yes! Come on! God day, so we day. 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 Inside God day, so we day. 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 Inside God day, God day. God day, God day. So we day. Inside God day. So we dey inside Superu, 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 Peru, Peru, Superu, Superu. Back, 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 back to sender, back to sender, car, 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 back to sender. God dey, so we dey, God dey, so we dey.
Well, they prepared for this journey, this fight. There was one key weapon they needed all along, and that was prayer. For nothing can and will be achieved without prayer. Everything by prayer. Praying always, praying without ceasing.
Better be music.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, la, 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 la. There is nothing without prayer, so my brother wake up now. There is nothing without prayer, so my sister stand up now. Hey. 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 Hey.
pray, just pray, your life will change. Oh, oh, just pray, your life will never be the same. Pray, pray, pray.
My dear, now they were set for their walk, their fight with Christ, and the rest was praise, praising their father and boasting of his power, telling everyone to know by now that anything that comes their way, knowing that they put their faith in God, they will surely overcome, and nothing can bring them down. What kept blowing their mind was how previously sinful men are now loved genuinely by the Father. And so they continue praising for such an unconditional love, a love without clause, an amazing love that had been shown to them.
Hello, mate. Yeah, that's how I started off. You should know by now. That's right, I'm hard to stop. You should know by now. If you wanna try to sing, I laugh it off. You can't bring me down. Got first, so I never come second, and you should know by now. Come through with a blessed flow. Ain't saying I'm next to blow. I'm giving it my best, you know. And a little bit extra, yo. So anything that come my way, I will overcome the right way. I put my faith in God, and there ain't a lie in my nice fit. And I know that time you have for a reason. Winter, spring, summer, autumn, survive through any season. Even when I walk through the valley, I keep believing. And you don't know.
For my loving me, gently. Blessings of blessings to follow me. Loving me, yo, loving me, yo. Like the western love,
to the way you love me, gently. To the way you did bless me, gently. To the things you did do me, gently. Everything you did do me, gently. To the way you did love me, gently. To the way you did bless me, gently. To the things you did do me, gently. I said I gently, 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 gently.
Yeah, sent for my loving me, gently. Blessings of blessings to follow me. Loving me, yo. Like the western love anomalies. Speaking in tongues, who's on to the da. Let me more do when I won't be that. Won't be that when I wait to read that. Brand in turn on the bed to open. Wait till they cast in a man who are done. Ask and receive, knock and open doors. Said that he loved us with no other cross. With no other cross, yes, cause I know the bar. See the love and love it is, so he showed me we are not the bar. See the blessings where they fall on me, Lord. Yeah, loving me properly. Spiritual connection, totally. Waiting be poverty, waiting be frustration. Where God be my property. Guiding me, every day. Forgiving man them, nothing day. Hiding me, safer place. Protecting your boy from all disgrace. I walk through the valley of the shadow of death and life. Cause your boy passed and failed. 1,000 on left, 10,000 on right. But still with the pass to the midfield. Suck at it, spiritually wired. They love you, they show me, yeah. Positive, positive. I go do everything, make a day side, trust me.
Chukwamame, all of my giju maya. Chukwamame, ihuna jagi na samusa. Chukwamame, jihoma. Ome ijoma, ome iyuko.
Oh, you're so amazing.
Amazing grace, amazing life you gave me.
You're so assuring.
Assuring love in you, my life secure.
You're so amazing.
If you are leave, I knew I had my being.
You're so amazing, you amaze me. I love you. You love me,
Jaja, 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 Jaja,
That was a wonderful ministration by Aroma of Christ. You want to put your hands together for them one more time?
Right. And we're still being reminded that as Judah Praise is a worship program, it's still a giving platform. So you will want to acknowledge that there are certain numbers that are rolling below the screens. So you will want to donate to a worthy cause.
Yes, we are trying to help the children of the pediatric ward pay their bills. And so you can be a blessing in one way or another. Next on the bill, ladies and gentlemen, this is it. The final, fourth, last package. Help us welcome F.O.G.
Wherever you are, I want you to be in the moment of worship. If you can be on your feet. Whatever you have lost, be it time, any form of resource, let's know that the Lord of revival will restore it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, whatever is worrying you, whatever is a burden, He will give you rest in the name of Jesus. So even as we are about to worship, I would ask that you join.
Let the rain of your presence abundance, Lord. We need it, Lord. We need it, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Is someone happy to be in the presence of the Lord? Hallelujah. Amen. One more time, we want to give praise and glory unto Jesus. We thank God for such an awesome program. We thank God for the revival. Hallelujah. We want to sing and dance in the presence of the Lord. And as we sing and we dance as the last activity of this event, we are leaving a deposit of the revival of God in your house, in your room, in your family, wherever you find yourself. We are declaring that through this praise, there is going to be a revival in your house. Amen. If you believe it, put your hands together and give the Lord a mighty celebration. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let the people sing.
FOG, we enjoyed ourselves. We are in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Indeed, amen. Yes. To give us the vote of thanks this evening is our very own mama, a very anointed woman of God. She can't be compared to anybody. That is why she is who she is.
That's right.
This is the president of the Christian Medical Fellowship, CMF-KATH. Let us welcome Vanessa Abokoma Quay.
You want to do it better for her? She is looking lovely.
Whoosh. Hallelujah! You want to give the Lord a resounding shout of joy? If you're excited to be in the house of God, if you're excited in your room, you want to be on your feet, you want to raise your hands, you want to slap them together to the goodness of God, give the Lord a shout. I don't know about you, but I'm extraordinarily revived in this place. You know, if you are found in a place where you feel that there are dry bones all around you, in your finances, in your health, I see me telling you that there is a north wind coming to you. There is a south wind coming to you. There is a west wind coming to you. There is an east wind coming to you. If you believe that the four winds are gathered together to cause an increase in your life, to cause a revival in your life, give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah. God is good. And all the time. Indeed, God is good. He has made sure that this day has come to fruition. And we want to give all the praise and thanks to him. Just want to give a big round of applause to our daddy up there. Daddy, thank you so much for making this a blessing. Want to thank our guest speaker as well, Pastor Joshua. Thank you so much for that powerful exhortation and for leading us through the fundraiser. We say, Papa, God richly bless you. We can't leave without thanking the ministries. Uncle Bernard, we want to thank the media team. The media team, guys, let's give it up for the media team. They've been so amazing. PK, the transport team, CCC, please let's clap for them. They've just been amazing. They've been with us all through, making sure that this program comes to being. We can't forget our lighting people, Uplight Concepts. God bless you for being with us all through for this program as well. I personally want to thank our ministers, Aroma of Christ, family, and FOG, friends of God. These are medical students. Hallelujah. You think that these medical students stay in the consulting room and collect patients, but God has blessed us with a gift. And they are out here using it to bless people. Amen. God bless you, ministers of God. I want to thank those who gave to the fundraising committee, those who gave when we came to them, Spectral Health, all the students, all the lecturers, all the doctors, thank you so much. The kids at the PEDX Ward say thank you so much. Rita says thank you for giving. Those who are yet to give, we want to encourage you. And God should bless you and touch your heart and your gift to the glory of God. Amen. Amen. And you listening to me, I can't leave without thanking you for staying through from the beginning of the program to the end of the program. And I know you have been blessed. I know you have been revived. I know the God of revival has met you in this place. Amen. You want to stand to your feet with me? Hallelujah. Wherever you are, just stand to your feet and close your eyes. And I'm about to say the closing prayer. I don't know what you took from this place. I know that every dry bone in someone's life has been revived. Anyone who had a headache, a tummy ache, a leg pain, I see that revival touching you through the screens. just want to thank God for this program, this revival. You want to pray personally and tell God that let this revival stay in this place. I know that you probably might have been depressed, but after this meeting, this peace of God has transcended you. That is the revival speaking to you. Just want to pray that, Lord, let this revival stay. Rencos ipranos ipala bradosas, labrados ibalos ibala labadasas, randelebos es ibranos adiat, rambalalabata. Thank you, Jesus. Balorobos ipanos adiatus. Thank you, God, for a time like this. Thank you, God, that we have gathered together to give you praise. Thank you that the winds of revival has run through every closet in this place. Thank you that we are hearing the sound that comes with that revival, that anyone with any bones has the ligament and the tendons and the muscles coming together in their life, and the breath of God has moved through them, that they have become an army, ready to make sure that the generations yet unborn are glorified. Thank you, O God, for being with us from the beginning to the end of the program. We give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration in Jesus' mighty name. We want to take the benediction. We want to share the grace. Hallelujah. Shall we share the grace wherever we are? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. God bless you for watching. I want to personally thank you for joining us fellowship tonight. But you know, you are wondering what we are speaking about. We are speaking about the God of revival. We can't have a revival without the God. So I want to give you watching me the opportunity to know this God of revival. If you've been with us and you feel you have an empty space in the inside of you waiting to be filled, you've been through the whole service and you feel that you need to touch this God. You need to take hold of this God. You want to join me, give your life to Christ by saying this prayer. Father, thank you, O God, for tonight that I've met you in this place. I give my life to you in this place. I accept Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior. Come and be my Lord and personal Savior. Come and be with me throughout my life. Thank you for writing my name in the book of life. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Beloved, if you said this prayer, you're welcome to the family of revivalists. Hallelujah. You want to pen down your name in the chat box and we'll contact you. You want everyone to know the testimony that you have come to Christ. God bless you. This is Judah Praise 2021, the God of revival.